Hey guys, how are y'all? All right, so I just wanted to come on here live and talk to you a bit about how I'm feeling and answer that question that everybody seems to have. Hopefully you can hear me because they have this background music. We're actually charging the Tesla, and so I took an opportunity to come into the hotel and do this live because I think it's really important, and I wanted to have a few minutes with you guys today to talk about this very important question: should I work out whenever I'm sick? And you know, for those of you guys that are new to the page, thank you so much for joining. And I just want to say, hey, Rebecca, I see that she's on. I wanted to let you know that my name is Missy Mo, and I am a health and fitness mindset ninja coach, for short. And, or that should be long. But anyway, I want to, you know, just help you to figure out this whole, process of learning how to make health and fitness a part of your lifestyle, to where you can, you know, be a role model to your family and your friends, and to where you can set up a legacy that you will be proud of. And sometimes that's easier said than done, because sometimes, you know, things happen in our lives and we have to learn how to go over those bumps and get through them, pass through them, and then get to the other side. And so with that, today I wanted to talk to you about, should you work out if you're sick? I am actually sick right now, as you can tell from the post, and you can probably tell from my red eyes, and hopefully I don't cough during this little live, but I have 95% positive that I have strep. I went to the doctor yesterday, and it was really early, and so he said that the strep test pretty much came out positive, but he offered me to take a cortisone shot to help with the inflammation right away to counteract it, and then also to make me feel better really quickly. And because I had a sore throat, I had the stuffy nose, I had the post-nasal drip, congestion was starting, I was starting with this dry, hacky cough. And so, and I went to the doctor because I have a baby shower for my daughter on Sunday that I need to be available for, as I am hosting it. And also, I had this trip today, which was an amazing, once in a lifetime opportunity that I wanted to come and partake in, because I don't know if you know this, but I used to play basketball whenever I was a kid, and I love basketball, so I get to go to Houston Rockets basketball game, and we have amazing seats. So I just had to do this. And so I went to the doctor, which I normally would not do because I'm a nurse, and as a nurse, we're the hardest patients, and we always try to do everything over the counter first before going to the doctor. And then by the time we get to the doctor, we're way sick. Well, hence, I have learned from, in the last couple of years, that that's probably not a good idea. And so I like to jump on it right away now. And so that's what I did, because I had these two events. Hey, Renee, how are you? And hopefully you guys can hear me, so please say hi in the comments below so I can see that you can hear me. And if you watch the replay, because this is the rebroadcast, please put hashtag replay so I can know that you're on watching the rebroadcast. All right, but anyway, so listen up, guys. I used to be balls to the wall, and I would work out whenever I was sick. Yes, I would do some type of a workout. I may not work out as intensely as I would on a regular day, okay, whenever I'm not feeling well, but I would work out. I would push my body to the point where, it was doing more damage than good. So usually I would get sicker, and then I'd have to miss work and all that kind of stuff. But today I know the difference. Today I know that I have to take care of myself, and I have to back it up a bit, because that's what's good for my body, and that's what's good for my soul. I don't have to worry so much that I'm gonna lose everything that I gained over the last 4 years in my journey, okay? You don't lose it that quick. Hey, Tamara, how are you, girl? And you have to balance. You have to have balance. Thanks, girl. you have to have balance, and you have to know what's okay for your body next. So today I'm taking a complete rest day, and that's so unusual. I mean, it was funny. I was posting on my Instagram story, and it was like, okay, yes, I know it's a Wednesday, and it's totally in the middle of the week, kind of crazy, but that's what I have to do because I want to be better for this weekend. And then tomorrow, after we come back from Houston, I'm going to like wait until late in the day, and I'll do a yoga workout or some stretching or something just to move my body. But I'm not going to get my heart rate up. I'm not going to like get all hot and sweaty because that's not going to help. And I'm going to listen to what the doctor said. And that's like a big thing, right? Because who knows? What does a doctor know, right? Whenever they tell you not to work out. That's what I used to always think. But now, with some resistance, I am going to listen to what the doctor says. And I'm gonna do it right now. If I'm feeling bad tomorrow night, I will not work out. And so I will judge it. So one day at a time. But I know now that it's okay. Now sometimes, if you are sick, or you're depending on what you're sick with, you may be able to work out, okay? But in this instance, with what I have going on right now with the infection that I have, it's not wise for me to work out and push my body. So I want you guys, thank you, Rebecca, I'm glad it's valuable to you. I want you to know that if you cannot get out of bed because you're sick, if you cannot, I mean, you can't work out, right? I mean, that's crazy thinking. So just don't push yourself. I remember whenever I was doing Max 30, whenever I, like 4 years ago, and I remember like doing yoga because I was like, if I can just do yoga, then I would do it. And so that's what I would do. And so today it's like I'm taking it one day at a time. So make sure that you take one day at a time as you go through your sickness and your illness, and that you just take care of yourself and know this. Now the Tesla is charged, so I gotta jump and I gotta go. But I just wanted to tell y'all hi, and I love you. And if this made any sense to you, please share it, or you know, send it out to your friends, or save it to where you can have it for future reference. But just know to listen to your body, okay? All right, love you guys. Bye.